Eminem, the greatest rapper of all time, the greatest, the king of hip-hop. Is he a guest?
I said, what? First of all, this motherfucker is not the fucking greatest of all time. He's not the king of hip-hop. And yes, motherfucker, he's a guest.
I never was being claiming rap, but it's not yours. If it was anyone's house, G-Rap and Rock Kim, it'd be having you mop floors. Run DMC, it'd be having you cleaning sinks. Yeah, your group was off the chain, but you were the weakest link.
Oh, okay, you know what? Let me just say this. Lyrically? When it comes to putting words together, yeah, he's better than me.
I'm in your house eating carrot cake, while I sit there and wait and I marinate. I'm irritated, you about to meet a scary fate and come home to find yourself staring straight into a fucking barrel like Sharon Tate. Raise a concerto while I narrate.
He couldn't be talking about my real home because he'd be shot dead. And actually, as the homeowners in hip-hop, I believe we do have the right to expel anybody that comes up in our fucking house that we do not deem a welcome guest.
I told the woke me to go to sleep, but still they keep on provoking me. They're hoping to see me completely broken emotionally. But how in the fuck am I not supposed to be woke when these fuckers just keep poking me now?
If somebody said right now Eminem is the king of rap, why would you say he's not?
You got to come with a better name.
Yeah. That ain't even worth.
All right.
Because I ain't playing Eminem in my car.
Man, I love Gucci. He was one of the first people like, hey, bro. We can go handle it. I was like, Gucci.
Gucci wanted to handle Eminem.
I know the king of rap.
Who?
Me. You.
Only way that you're ahead of me is alphabetically, because if you diss me, I'm coming after you like the letter V.
What's up, fight fans, moviegoers, Jedis, and Sith? I'm Jake Cotto, the Boxing Jedi, and welcome to the Boxing and Jedi's Temple. And check this out, man. Eminem dropped the video. Or should I say a new? Well, he dropped some videos, dropped a couple of tracks, and next thing you know, he dropped a brand new album on us again. It's called Music to Be Murdered By, no doubt. And I'm gonna tell you something right now, man. This shit is another classic, dog. Like, this is basically the flag planted in the shit. What you saw in the beginning was everything that happened. I think it was last year when he dropped Kamikaze and all this beef where motherfuckers were telling him he wasn't, you know, part of hip hop and all this bullshit. Well, now this man has dropped another fucking album. You know what I mean? Thanos has dropped another album, Music to Be Murdered By. And I'm gonna tell you something right now. This shit is fire. It is fucking fire, man. It's fire. And the album cover was inspired by Alfred Hitchcock, because Alfred Hitchcock did a photo shoot with something similar to that. I just gotta say, man, I'm happy that he's back. He's basically covering grounds. He's letting everybody know, man, I still got the crown, and I couldn't agree more, man. I mean, you know what I'm saying? All these guys are mad, but they're not really doing anything. Think about everything that Eminem has done in hip hop, right? If my man surpassed LL Cool J, who had 30 years of longevity, the Vanguard Award, if Eminem has surpassed all of that, bro, then who you think is ahead of rap? Not Jay-Z. See, money ain't got nothing to do with this. See, like he said, if it had to do anything with Skrilla, which is money, he would have quit a long time ago. So it ain't even about money. And for a man at this caliber to still, like, my man could whisper shit and sneeze on a mic, son. And this man would definitely go platinum, son. Like he said, his bad album, his worst album, that your fucking Revival and Relapse, I think it was. And y'all said it was whack, and you know what I mean? A lot of you guys didn't understand, man. You know, he was filling out his lyrics, and he was basically catering to those that were saying, oh, he's too this, he's too that. He's too rough, he's too toxic, you know? And he went and experimented with his style, and a lot of y'all didn't, you know, you didn't appreciate that. And there's a lot of artists out there that are going to experiment with their style. You know, they're going to do a lot of things with their style of music, and they're going to see how, you know, how this sounds. They're going to hit different topics, you know what I mean? Different flows, you know? Some change up their image. I'm going to say something right now, man. If anybody disagrees, and they say they follow hip-hop, they say they know hip-hop, and I'm excluding the ones of today, I don't got nothing to do with this era. But those that are like my age, all the way to like, I would say 32, right? If you guys are actually not giving this man the crown, and you're giving it to somebody like 6ix9ine or any of these fucking, I'm sorry, but you don't know shit about hip hop. And this is not an opinion. This is nothing to really, we can debate about it, but you're going to lose if I take up for M. Or if anyone takes up for M, they're going to lose. They're going to lose. Just like you're going to lose the argument as to where, if you debate a motherfucker about hip hop just being for straight, you know, just being for African Americans, and it was made by African Americans, you're going to lose that all the time. You're going to lose that all the time. You had Big Pun, who went platinum, Puerto Rican rapper, right? You had Jin. You had so many different races, diversity. Hip-hop is diverse, man, and it's a culture. And for Lord Jamal and the rest of these fucking skin politic plain-ass motherfuckers to come out and just say, Eminem doesn't belong. But yet these motherfuckers haven't done a goddamn thing. Being behind a podcast and all this bullshit has nothing to do with hip-hop. I mean, you're contributing, but you're really not really doing anything, son. It's a different extension to hip-hop. And Eminem is the direct extension to hip-hop. Plus, you got Dr. Dre, the great... If you guys are saying Dr. Dre is the greatest beat maker and the greatest producer, then you have to give it hands down. And I'm going to close the argument right now. If Dr. Dre is the world's greatest hip-hop beat maker and producer, we've all agreed upon this, then standing right next to him, because basically he helped him and he full-fledged him, right, is the world's greatest MC right now. I'm Jay Cotto. God bless, stay vigilant. Peace.